this tab and the link to the agenda will appear to the right hand side. This will allow you to open the agenda in PDF format and follow the decision and the debate. My role is to ensure that the committee will speedily have regards to procedure, behaviour and ethics. Welcome to this evening's meeting for the Regulation Purposes Committee. I have received apologies from Councillor Hodgson, who is the Chair of the Regulatory and General Purposes Committee. My name is Stephen Bennett and as Vice Chair I will be chairing this meeting this evening. Councillor Ian Lewis is deputising for the Chair. Apologies for absence. I have also received apologies for absence from Councillors Mary Jordan, with Andrew Gardner, Councillor Arthur Gardner deputising, and Richie Pitt, with Councillor Daisy Kelly deputising. Thank you. Before you do any further, is there any declarations of interest? Do any members have any declarations of interest in respect to the items on this agenda this evening? No. Okay, item four is public member and questions. There's no questions from members or any statements or petitions being received from members. However, there is a question from a member of public. Mr. Bryce, please come forward. Thank you.
Yes, this is a short question. It's in relation to page 37 on the agenda. There's a table on the agenda item by honorary Freedom of the Boa Coast Humorous Award, Paula Gray, it's a table of past recipients of the Freedom of the Boa. All of them have a year that they were awarded the Park on the Hills in 96, and the question was basically why was the year omitted for the Hills in 96 being awarded Freedom of the Boa. Thank you.
Okay, thanks very much. I'll pass that on to our Sir Robert Chris, which has spoken on board.
Hi, so there was an omission for the year which has been noted and it will be minuted and also addressed as part of the report.
Okay, thank you. I don't answer that question.
Okay, thanks for your question. Next, item five, which is minutes. This is to approve the minutes and accuracy of the minutes of the meeting held on the 23rd of March 2023. May I have them approved, please? Agreed. Next item on the agenda is item six. It's minutes of the regulatory panel. To approve the accuracy and the minutes of the regulatory panel, now named the licensing panel, meetings held on the 3rd of March 2023, the 5th of April 2023, 28th of April 2023, and the 28th of April 8:23 p.m. Can we read those minutes, please? Okay. Okay. We move on to item number 7, which is appointment to members of the licensing panel and the charitable trusts. And there was, of course, this set to outline that report.
Thank you, Chair. The purpose of this report is simply for the Regulatory General Purposes Committee to note the process for appointing members to the Charitable Trust, the subcommittee and the licensing panel, and to note the terms of reference of the Charitable Trust subcommittee and the licensing panel as referred to in paragraphs 1.1, 1.2 and 1.3 of this report, terms of reference having been approved and agreed by Council late last month. The report is also requesting the Director of Law and Governance through your monitoring officer to be authorised to carry out the wishes of the group leaders in allocating members to membership of the Charitable Trust Subcommittee and to appoint those members with effect from the date at which she as proper officer is advised the names of such members. I appreciate that this may not be this evening, but if the names could be put forward via Ms. Bushan, the committee clerk, that would be of great assistance. Members will note that the appointment of the five members as agreed at Council is politically balanced and that the appropriate ratios are set out in paragraph extent that the licensing powers can be formed from at least two member groups of the council, two member groups of the council. So that will enable, make it easier for administrative purposes in order to be able to have quorum, to be quorum in order to hear the various applications that will be coming the way of the licensing panel in the next municipal meeting. I don't think I have anything further else to add to that. Clearly, if members wish to query, I'm happy to ask any questions, answer any questions.
Has anyone got questions from Paul Solicitor? Okay, so I move forward and ask people if they could formally propose and second this nomination, please.
I'm formally proposed.
Thank you.
Second.
So, thanks very much. And I advise they can get a list of names from each particular party within the next, say, 7 days to the committee clerk so they can work out who's going on the next on the child resources. Okay, thanks very much. We move on then to item number 8, which is conferment of title on the organ. So, yes, if you take over that one.
Thank you, Chair. So, the report requests the committee to consider whether to recommend to council that the title of honorary alderman be conferred on former councillors Tony Smith and Dave Mitchell. The Wirral Plan 21-26 sets out the council's vision to secure the best possible future for the council's residents and covers the following 5 themes: thriving and inclusive economy, creating jobs and opportunities for all, a clean energy, sustainable borough leading the way in tackling the environment crisis, brighter futures for all regardless of their background, safe and pleasant communities that all residents are proud of, and healthy and active lives for all with the right care at the right time. By recommending the recognition of eminent service to the community, the proposals within this report align with the theme of safe and pleasant communities that our residents are proud of. This matter affects all wards within the borough. For recommendations, the Regulatory and General Purposes Committee is requested to recommend to Council the conferment of the title of Honorary Alderman on former councillors Tony Smith and Dave Mitchell in accordance with section 249(1) of the Local Government Act 1972. Happy to take any questions that anyone may have.
Is there any other questions for Chris? Okay. So we'll move forward with the proposer and second for that then. So you have a proposer, please.
I'll propose, Chair.
Thank you, Mike. Will I second that?
I'll second, Chair.
Thanks very much, Andrew. Okay, with that we shall move forward then and go to our item 9, which is the Only Freedom of the Borough Posthumous Award for O'Grady and BDL. Again, Chris.
Thank you, Chair. Under the Local Government Act 1972, the Council has the power to grant the title of Honorary Freeman or Freewoman of the Borough to persons of distinction who have rendered eminent service to the Borough. This is a very significant step for the Council to take. Very few people have been awarded this status, and it should only be awarded to someone who has made an exceptional contribution to the borough. Paul O'Grady, MBE, DL, comedian, broadcaster, actor and writer, who was born and raised in Birkenhead and who sadly passed away on the 28th of March 2023, aged 67, is considered to be within this category. Past recipients are listed in the report, and the Hillsborough 96 omission of date has been noted and will be reflected in the minutes. The Wirral Plan 2021-26 sets out the Council's vision to secure the best possible future for the Council's residents and covers the 5 themes that I mentioned within my previous report. By recommending the recognition of eminent service to the community, the proposals within this report align with the theme of safe and pleasant communities that our residents are proud of. And if recommended to Council and subsequently approved, a scroll will be presented to a family representative by the Mayor. This matter affects all wards within the borough. The Regulatory and General Purposes Committee are requested to recommend to Council that, in pursuance of the provisions of Section 249, Section 5 of the Local Government Act, and in recognition of his dedicated service to the borough, that Paul O'Grady, MBE, be posthumously admitted as Honorary Freedom of this borough at an extraordinary council meeting to be held on the 10th of July 2023, and officers be requested to take all necessary actions associated with the above and arrange for a small civic reception for family representatives of Paul O'Grady and some invited guests on a mutually agreeable date following the extraordinary meeting of the council. Happy to take any questions that anybody may have.
Two questions, Chair. One is the Hillsborough 96 were mentioned there, and we gave posthumously to the 96, and it was a great night here in the Town Hall. But it just brought to mind the Hillsborough 96 is actually now 97. So is that person who died, has he been awarded that? The other one is, you said we award the freedom of the borough to men and women. Well, does that mean that we award or we recommend the award for Paul O'Grady, and do we also recommend the award for Lily Savage? That's all.
Thank you very much for that, Councillor Sullivan. Any other questions? Okay, we'll move on then to, can we have a proposal for this?
Proposal.
Councillor Lang, proposal. Now the seconder, please.